Remember the Uber driver who was attacked, according to her, and the police did not seem to want to investigate. Well, we got on top of it, an investigation happened. Let me remind you of the video. Here it is. She is a musical entertainer, a writer, very talented individual. But that night she said she was in fear for her life. And she described right here on Indisputable, in all words, what happened to her. Here's the next video.
Hi guys, this is my update from the assault that happened on me when I was driving for Uber. This is the very first report that I made that same day, 12/17/2022. As you can see, I'm the only victim. And at the bottom, I was driving a 2022 Tesla. DPD was first on the scene. This was my first detective that was taking the case. And he told me, since further in the investigation, that it has to go to MSP because it happened on the freeway in their district. When I got to MSP and gave them my report, I showed them a picture of this man, the man that strangled me when I was begging for help. And they started to freak out.
All right, now she did come to Indisputable after we covered the story. An investigation was at that point ongoing. However, she said they wanted to close it out either that day or the day after and had not obtained the witnesses nor their statements on record as of yet. We said that is not acceptable. Now, there's a phone conversation. All right, a phone conversation she has where there's a conflicting statement we must analyze. Here is Desiree on the phone with Trooper Chadwick Carpenter, who says they didn't know the man who choked her on the freeway. Here it is.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure on the other males that were there. Like I said, I'm investigating the assault that Nico committed on you, so.
I hope you really get all of this.
So I don't know about other guys there or anything like that, and that really doesn't have anything to do with the assault. So. Right.
What about the man that choked me?
What about him?
Did you have him too?
We do not know who that is at this moment. I'm trying to figure that out, but we do not know who that is. So right now it remains a mystery.
Oh my God.
They don't know who it is, but the police responded. They were there. They don't know who it is. They responded. They were at the scene. They were supposed to at least know who was there, involved. There's more. Trooper Carpenter on the phone with Desiree. That was really interesting, right? But Desiree says Trooper's commander, who's a lieutenant, named Lance Cartier, who says they do have the number of the man who choked her. Here it is.
Trooper Carpenter, like I said, he has reached out to all three different numbers, the two that you gave me, and then also the other persons that drove the other person home. Mm-hmm. But he just can't get in touch with any of them, like all three, both the two that you gave me for Amir and I forget the other lady's name.
His name Brown?
Yep. And then like I said, there was another, the people that drove the guy that was in your car home from there. Like I said, none of them are answering.
Whoever drove him home, I don't know them.
Well, I'm not saying you do. I'm saying that he got a phone number for those people and he's tried calling them and they're not answering their phones either.
The police are literally saying, hey, now we tried to call them. Nobody answered the phone. I don't know what else you want us to do here. Wow. Let's put her picture up full mass. Desiree Keys, a musician from Detroit, Michigan, says she was driving her passenger in Uber. At that time, she worked for Uber. around 3 a.m. This was December 17th on Interstate 94 headed toward Detroit. Her passenger named Nico in the app. All right, let me make that very clear. In the app, it says Nico started acting strangely, according to her. He, according to the allegation, asked her how she could afford such a nice car. Then she says he made another request and said, "Can you sell me drugs?" According to the Uber driver, you're looking at the passenger from the video that we do have on record. When next, she says he threatened to kill her. Keys stopped on the interstate and demanded he get out. She told police the passenger grabbed her head by her weave and ripped one of her braids, slapped her, and dumped his drink on her seats and got close to her face to push her. Now, I want you to keep that picture up. You see that substance on the seat? According to Ms. Keys, she believes it was a form of liquid drugs. And the police at the scene refused to take a sample in order to confirm what the substance he dumped out was. Next, Keys and the eyewitness said a second man got out of his Dodge Ram to intervene, misreading the scene. She says the man put her in a chokehold, and according to her, this is the man in question. Now, granted, the witness does say that the man misread the situation and thought something else was going down. Desiree says the blonde man choked her on the freeway and drove her abusive passenger home. Let me give you the current investigator. Hey, remember that first voice you heard? That's him. This is Trooper Chadwick Carpenter. He is the current investigator. Initially, the witnesses, including Amir Nunn, said Indisputable was the first to contact her. Since our initial broadcast, she has given a statement to the police. Nunn described the freeway fight scene to Indisputable. She said, and I quote, "Everyone's like, as if she's the aggressor, she's the angry one. And the man that she was fighting, her attacker, he was also playing the victim as if he didn't provoke her to do what she did." She was defending herself, was the point of the witness. She was defending herself because the guy continued to approach her aggressively, to charge at her and to physically assault her, according to the narrative. All right? Now, we made contact with her, no problem. None. She gave us a statement, but according to the popo, they could not find her. They could not reach her, and they were going to close the investigation. There's more. Both Lieutenant Lance Currier and Trooper Carpenter, the guy you just saw, have been in contact with Desiree Keys, and their investigation remains open as of now. They identified her passenger by the first name Nicholas. Keys' public records request to the Michigan State Troopers for the police report has now been delayed. They requested an additional 10 days to comply with the legally authorized command. You have a right to that information. And there's your request. All right. So everyone sees it should not take this much for what happened. You see, a proper investigation in the front end of this would have resulted in an actual outcome that would not have to be televised. But because you decided to not engage in an appropriate manner, I'm talking to the police, because there was obvious neglect in the investigation, in my opinion, we're here. But I'm okay with us being here if we must. Now, gentlemen, we could keep playing this game, or you could simply investigate the matter as it is and present the evidence to the proper authorities and move on with your lives. Simple. Do your damn jobs. Jordan, thoughts here?
Hey, I'm mystified why the police can't do what they normally do in this situation, which is just physically go to someone's house or work or wherever they are and ask them questions, talk to them, get their statement. They have no problem doing that in other scenarios, and many of which we've covered on this show. You have spent the past couple of years covering stories where they'll show up and engage in acts of violence. But now, when they need to get a statement or interrogate a white man who held someone in a chokehold, they just make one or two phone calls and that's it. I that maybe they have really busy days hiding behind a bridge where on parts of the freeway where the speed limit changes so they can give people tickets.
Obviously.
It's much more important to do that, I guess.
Yeah, it's insane. We will obviously keep everyone updated on this saga. Hopefully the investigation will be administered properly.